was the youngest signer of the United States Constitution? Hi, Founder fans. Jason here, and today we'll be discussing Jonathan Dayton. Now, Jonathan Dayton got a head start at being a founder when he dropped out of college at just 15 years old. He joined the 3rd New Jersey Regiment of the Continental Army as an ensign, which meant he was actually an officer at that young an age. It's the lowest level officer you could be, but still an officer nonetheless. Now, it helps when you have people in high places, because his father just so happened to be the colonel who led that regiment. Now, they went out and ended up shortly thereafter serving in the New Jersey campaign, and specifically, they ended up at Valley Forge, the harsh winter with George Washington that the army survived those times that try men's souls, if you will. So Dayton would go on and actually serve with the Sullivan-Clinton campaign in upstate New York, where they traveled through burning Native American villages in retribution for and in an effort to prevent further attacks on frontier settlements. After this, during this time, Dayton was actually captured and taken prisoner for the whole winter, but fortunately he was released in the spring of 1781 and would make it back to the main army just in time to be present for the Battle of Yorktown. And Jonathan Dayton had spent almost a full 7 years at war. And that's a long time when you're a very young man. So Dayton would go back to New Jersey, and he would finish his studies and open a law firm and become fairly successful. And he was shortly thereafter, still a very young man, elected to the state assembly. And when, in the summer of 1787, they chose delegates to go to Congress to write the Constitution, this young man still was chosen and did go to the Constitutional Convention. Now, he did speak a little bit, but as the youngest person there, Dayton didn't participate too strongly. He wasn't very influential in the creation of the Constitution, but on September 17th, 1787, he was the youngest person to sign the United States Constitution just a month before his 27th birthday. Yes, he was still 26 years old when he signed the United States Constitution. Now, Dayton was actually elected as an inaugural member of the United States House of Representatives. Again, still in his 20s, but he declined the initial election. However, 2 years later, when there was a second election, he was then elected and accepted the position of Congressman for the United States. Again, not quite 30 years old. Now, during the 1790s, he would stay there, and he would actually be chosen as the Speaker of the House for almost four years, as, again, one of the youngest people in the room. And as the Speaker of the House, he basically controlled what was on the floor because he was the leader of the majority party. Now, Dayton was a Federalist, and this was during the Washington administration leading into the Adams administration, so it was very Federalist-heavy. So it wasn't that unusual for his party to be in charge, but for a young man just hitting 30 years old, it was fairly strange. So Dayton would go on to be elected to the United States Senate, and that's when things would go a little bit wrong. Because after his friend, whose name was Aaron Burr, gotten some heat by getting in a little bit of a duel with Alexander Hamilton, he loaned his friend Aaron Burr some money to go adventuring out west. Now, it turns out Aaron Burr may or may not have been trying to do what was then called a filibuster, which is unlike what we call a filibuster today. A filibuster then was basically raising an army and invading New Spain, invading Mexico, invading New Orleans. So he did give Burr some money. He loaned him some money to go on his adventures. Now, Burr was accused of treason, and actually, so was Jonathan Dayton. Now, how much did Dayton know about what Burr was spending his money on is unclear, but Dayton was actually tried for treason while a sitting member of the United States Senate. He was, of course, cleared, and we should forgive him for any accusations because it was decided that he had no idea what Burr was doing out there with the money he had loaned him. Now, unfortunately, though we might forgive him, and the nation legally forgave him, the court of public opinion certainly did not, and his political image was tarnished. and he returned to New Jersey, returned to private life. He did end up serving in public office for his state on occasion during the remainder of his life, because he had a lot longer to live, because he was only about 45 when this all went down. And he did serve New Jersey, but mostly seemed to have lived a quiet and, by all accounts, happy life. But that is Jonathan Dayton. Oh, one more thing. You might have heard of the city of Dayton, Ohio. Well, if you know anyone who lives there, or have lived there, or just know about it, know that it was named after Jonathan Dayton, the youngest signer of the United States Constitution. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy it, please hit like. It helps me out a whole lot. And if you're new here, please subscribe. I talk about obscure American founders 5 days a week, plus we have a great live video on Saturday. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be back with another founder tomorrow.